Week two, this is November 10th. It's actually a Tuesday. We only started today because there was rain over the weekend and the Tesla crew had to wait it out, but they got here and it's a lot of people. As usual, I will document the entire process of them installing this. Right now they're on the roof. They secured the safety lines and what's happening today is they're installing the power walls.
Try and make it pretty, there's so many boxes.
We'll do our best. Try to keep it nice and square and neat.
Nice.
This is here is your main panel. It's showing the solar disconnect.
Right.
And the meter that's going on the side of the wall right here. They're showing our automatic relay and our load center going by the main panel here.
Okay.
And then over by those two windows are the two power walls, three DC disconnects, the inverter, and the AC disconnects for each individual power wall. So that's going to be over on that wall.
How long do you think is your part going to take, you think?
So it'll be today. Probably be here till about anywhere between 3 and 6 o'clock.
Okay. Today. And then it's a totally different crew that does the tile laying?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the solid roof crew.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. So we'll get started.
So far, what they've done is installed the flashing on all the corners and some metal rails on the roof. They're waiting on the tiles. I spoke to one of the crew members and he said that the tiles were supposed to arrive yesterday in the afternoon and they haven't shown up yet. So hopefully that's not gonna set them back. The other crew, they're right now installing the power wall and installing a sub panel for the electric.
This is a 200 amp rated sub panel.
Yeah.
But it's still interconnected with the utility company.
And then what's this?
That's the automatic relay switch. So that'll separate you from the utility company in the event of a blackout. It also houses pretty much the operating system for the power walls.
Cool.
I'll walk you through everything at the end of the install. Kind of give you an idea.
Okay, today is day 5 of the install. It's a Wednesday. Crew is there. They're waiting still on the tile. Maybe a little bit of a concern that it's gonna take longer. They're still busy working on all the flashing and ridges. They installed some metal rails of sorts. The other crew that was installing the power wall, it's all done. Yesterday I could see in my app that the batteries already showed up. They're right now not connected to the grid or they're not charging, but they're online, I can see them. Well, I'm gonna have to go and work some. Hopefully, by the time I come back, we'll see some tiles.
Good, how are you? Do you think you'll be done with the tiles today?
Definitely not today. My projected time for the deadline is going to be closer to Tuesday, probably. The tiles moved pretty fast. You know, we started laying them down after lunch when the delivery arrived yesterday, so we only worked for about 3 hours. So it'll start going fast if we have extra guys on site, but I think when it comes down to detail work, like metal custom fabrications, that's what tends to take a little extra longer. So.
Yeah, I spoke to somebody in the crew about the venting. We have a whole house fan, so we're actually pushing a lot of air into the attic. So we need a lot of venting. If we don't have enough venting, the air will come back into the house through the chimney.
Oh,
and
wow.
It'll blow the ashes.
Yeah, we have the entire ridge vented. Right now it's covered. So if you're experiencing that already, it's because the underlayment is covering it. Because, you know, we had the rain last week.
Yeah.
But it's certainly getting vented before we cover it up.
Okay, great. When you're done, maybe we'll just run a quick test just to make sure that it's
okay.
That it's enough venting.
And I don't know if you discussed this with the subcontractors, and we noticed that there may have been a remodel at some point of the house. It's more on the south end, where the hip extended to the back portion of the house. It looks like that's part of the extension.
Okay.
And just giving you a heads up, because it's not level and it's pretty significant, it kind of goes, it goes flat and then gradually declines. You may see a bit of an inconsistency based off the stagger of the way the tiles are installed and the footing.
Okay.
And that's just solely off the way the home is built. Yeah, just a heads up, and that's something that's just completely out of our control.
Yeah.
Now I know what those rails, those metal rails are for. That's to store the tiles before they install them. Really smart way, because that means less storage space required on the ground, and then also at night it's safe because nobody can steal it. The crew's been super nice. Every time like I walk onto the premise, they're like, hold the work, and everybody stops working. It's nice because they keep me in it safe. But at the same time, you kind of feel like, oh, I don't want to impede on them, so I'm going to stay inside more. The other thing is, they're all parking on the street here. And now the street is really busy. And yesterday we had trash day, so the trash, some of the cans weren't picked up because the cars were parked too close to the trash cans. They noticed that, and then they made sure that all those trash cans got emptied. So they took the trash so that all the neighbors are not upset because there's construction here.
Good, how are you?
Well, thank you.
Is this the inverter box, or what is this box here?
Yep, that's the inverter, and it's has a means of rapid shutdown for a DC disconnect. They actually require you to have a DC disconnect for each string. It's a lot of equipment, but you know, the H here requires it.
Is this for me? If something happens, I can go here and pull them, or?
Yep. However, the fastest means, you have two methods. If you want to just disconnect the DC side, there's a red switch on the bottom of the inverter.
This one right here?
Yep, you can turn that, and that would shut it off just in a second.
Okay, very cool.
How are you liking it so far?
I love it. I was a little worried about all these boxes, but there's some beauty to it.
Yeah.
It's like, I love that it says Tesla on that box.
Yeah, that's our new gateway too. Before, the relay switch looked similar to the one beneath it,
yeah,
which is a load center. But yeah, they just updated it.
And what does this do? Relay?
So it pretty much communicates with the app. So anytime there's a shutdown,
okay,
it's pretty much like the brain for the power wall.
Yeah.
It'll automatically trigger the batteries and then start that. And you wouldn't even know the power shut off.
That's awesome. Yeah, I already saw it on the app show up, so it's cool.
Oh yeah, by the end of today, you should be able to turn it on and see. I mean, obviously you don't want to turn it on until you have permission to operate, but you know, it should be up and running for today. It should be.
Oh really? So you're saying the panels are already feeding through the system?
It's not feeding, so you need a communication from the inverter before it produces.
Okay.
So right now it's kind of just like laying dormant.
Okay.
But yeah, we should get most of the electrical done today from on the ground.
Cool.
Today is Friday, November the 13th. Looking really good. There's still a bunch of roof sites that need some tiles on there. Today is the last day of the week, and then I'll come back on Monday to hopefully just a couple more days. If you're thinking about going solar, feel free to use my referral code, because it'll get you $250 off a system. Or if you're thinking about getting a Tesla car, it will also get you 1,000 free supercharging miles. Plus, I think we both are eligible for drawing of a Roadster, a Model Y, and some Powerwalls. Until next time, thanks for watching and keep things sunny.